client is click on these. A lot of people don't realize their cover image and the profile photos are actually clickable. So when you click it, you'll see there's a bit of a missed opportunity here. Someone actually did write in something. Do Android pets dream of electric food? Great opportunity here for the brand Growlies to get back in and reply with a joke or reply with something or other. At the very least, have some text here so that when people click on it, they get more information. Right now, there's nothing attached to that image. It's actually easy to do. I'll show you in a second. Same with this profile image here. When you click it, you just get the picture. And it actually looks like the old layout. It looks like the, which isn't a huge deal, although if you'll notice this thumbnail kind of is a little bit cut off. Let's go to my page, I'll show you how to fix that. But this is what I mean. So when I click my page, right now my cover image is advertising my Facebook summer school. If I click it, you'll see I've got details here on that. So if someone happens to click it, and in fact I kind of, with this being underlined, this link, I think people, there's unfortunately no way to direct it to when you click on your cover image to go to a particular website. All it'll go to is the image itself. But people click that and at least then they get some information. The intent of course happens, click more. And now that I see this, I may actually want to move this further up so that you'll see what happens is when you just click it by itself, it's sort of summarizes a bit of the information and it cuts it off after a certain point. So I want to move that call to image link up so that people don't have to click see more to get there. So here's how to do that, especially if you are Growlies and you're looking at that. We'll go back up to your cover image here. When you click on the cover image and you get this, just like I've done with mine, there's a little link here that says edit. Now you only get the ability to edit this on posts that have images attached to it. You can't do it with videos, you can't do it with status updates, you can't do it with link posts, although they are working on building that in. And Google Plus, you can do it with every post. But anyway, just click edit, and now you'll get this. Look at that. So I'm actually just going to move this more info and register up a little higher. I'm just cutting and pasting there, and then I'll say done editing. So now you see people, when they click see more, they don't have to see more, it's right up there. So that's how to do that. Back again here. So you see how it's kind of cut off here a little bit, your raw food pet destination. It's a little bit, you know, it's a little hard to see there. I might actually, remember that your brand goes along with this profile image, so you don't need to even repeat the name in here if you don't want to. Every time you post, it'll say Growlies for Pets beside it. But here, if you want to change it a little bit up, is as you hover over your profile picture. Now this only works if you are the admin on your page, but if you hover over it, you'll get this little thing that says edit profile picture. Click that and scroll down to edit thumbnail. Now here, if you want to, see how I can drag this around? You can actually drag it to whatever you want, or if you want to make it all fit, just click scale to fit. That's what I think Growlies should do in this case. If we go here, we take a look at it, when we click it, we're actually seeing that the image is quite a bit longer. Hey, it's much longer than the shape of that is, which is a square it's meant for. So I would redesign this, maybe even just put the cartoon characters in, or Growlies if you want to. But remember, let's just go back to their page and scroll through some of these posts, and you'll see, like right here, you can't really read it. It's kind of small anyway. So maybe you just want a big cat face in the cartoon or something. You're already going to get your brand mention right there. Either way. Okay, let's move on. This is great. They've put their hours of operation in. So if I click into that block there, you'll see they've posted their hours here. Well, one of the nice things that Facebook does, if we go back, is you'll see that it looks up the current time in this particular store's location and puts a green dot there if they're open. Right now as I record this, it's 5:04 at night, so they're less than an hour away from closing. If I came here at 5 minutes to 6, this would say closing soon. Like, they do a really nice job with this. Excellent that they've put in their address, so when I click on it, it will go and try to locate it, and it did a good job of that. It actually found it accurately on Bing's map, so good job there. So, you know, you only get one shot at editing this title. I would actually change this so that it's easier to search. If I don't know that I'm looking for a pet store in Victoria, if I don't know the name of the pet store in Victoria I'm looking for, I wouldn't know to type in Growlies. Here in Vancouver, I own 2 cats, so I would type in pet store Vancouver and see what pops up. So it looks like only one page has actually used all those phrases, and it's a nonprofit organization. But if one of the pet stores in my neighborhood had used pet store and Vancouver, if they used those words in the title of their page, it would pop up. So I would change the name of your page here to Growlies and then maybe colon Victoria Pet Store. so that people type it in, or pet supplies. Just look for the kind of things that people are searching for. One good way to do that is if you have Google Analytics or any analytics site on your website, go check to see what people are typing in to get there. What are the words people are searching for? Maybe it's cat supplies. Maybe that's the biggest one, in which case use that. So try to get people in there using the search terms in your title. Now, not a lot of people are talking. There's not a lot of engagement going on here. The way you can tell is you divide this number, which is how many people are talking about this page, which means they've mentioned the page or they've shared a post or something like that. They've created a story on their page. And right here, you divide it by that number. So I'm just going to do that really quickly. 10 divided by 538. And we discover that, see, and then you can do 1 times 100. So they're getting 1.85%. of engagement. Now, that's not bad. That means that almost 2 out of 100 people who stop off at this page talk about it. That's actually not bad. It's not particularly great. Usually we find the smaller the number of likes, the more engagement there is. You can drive this up by encouraging people to post, by, you know, instead of just this post, which says have a great reminder, or just a reminder that to have a great holiday weekend, I would have put, what are you doing this holiday weekend? Just something that encourages people to add a comment. So in addition to then your content being shown out on their news feed of all their friends, because it'll go to their friends' timelines, it also drives up your edge rank with them, meaning that they will see, the person who comments on your post will see more of your post in the future on their news feeds because they've engaged with your page. By way of example, if I like both Pepsi and Coca-Cola's page, I click like on both of those, and as I see their content in the news feed come up, if I only engage with Pepsi's page, right? If I click like on their post, if I comment on their post, and I don't comment on any of Coca-Cola's posts, eventually I will see fewer and fewer of Coke's posts. Now, Coke is still posting, I'm just not seeing it as much because Facebook says, you know, Todd wasn't really as engaged with Coke as he was with Pepsi, so we'll just show him more of Pepsi. So I'm going to add a comment here. Thanks. And now the simple fact that I've posted a comment means that I'm going to see more of these people's content. I'm going to see more of Growly's content in my newsfeed. So you should always be encouraging people to post comments on your thing. So how could we workshop some of these? Love it when veterinarians offer sensible advice like this article. So here's a great article. I would have put, what's the best piece of advice your veterinarian gave you? Here's another one. The diet you feed your dog food and cat should be balanced. What's your favorite dog and cat food? Would be a good question. The side benefit to that question is you sell the products, right? So if they say, my favorite is Royal Canin, you could say, we agree, we love Royal Canin. In fact, we stock their whole line. So it's a sales opportunity. But most importantly, just by having them comment, it increases the edge rank. They will see more of your content. So back up to the top here. Oops, come on, mouse. There we go, back up to the top. These four blocks are sort of your, they used to call these tabs. Facebook calls them apps right now. You can't change this one. Photos is always going to be in this position, but you can change the rest of them. And the way you do that is by clicking this little arrow here, the one that says two, which means there's two apps underneath that are available. I would actually take out likes, because we can always see, if you want to show off how many likes you have, I mean, if you've got 10,000, great. One of the pages that I administer, which is the unofficial Facebook fan page for the CBC, has got 99,453 likes. So I kind of like that likes there because I like to show it off a little bit. But you may not want to do that, in which case just hide it. I would also hide the map because the only thing this map is doing is showing you, actually just taking you to the about page. So it's kind of a missed opportunity there. Remember also people can get a map by just clicking your address. I noticed this contact form simply goes to a contact us form. That's okay. There's nothing wrong with having a contact us form. It kind of duplicates this message area right here. So what you may want to do just to kind of clean this up is to remove this contact app and just have an arrow, right? Design it in the cover image, an arrow that points down to this message button and say, send us a message. And when people click on it, they can send a message to your store. That's one way of doing it. Or if you really want to stick with this contact form, you know, maybe when people...